Esto viene como en un fade-in de un asado que, en el que ya se viene hablando mucho de música, y como Jim viene hablando mucho de opinando de sonidos, de músicos y todo, me interesa empezar hablando de sus discos preferidos, viendo que claramente es un nerd del asunto.
Miren esto, QN.
No, esto va a ser editado. Vamos a esto lo voy a editar yo. Esto lo voy a editar.
Vamos a aprender en inglés ya de la tarde.
He wants that our audience see me talking in English.
In like an Indian.
I will edit this part.
Okay.
We want to start talking about, because we are talking about a lot of musicians. Mm-hmm. I want to talk about your favorite guitar albums today or always. But okay. Something that you say, listen this 1, 2, 3 albums that I love.
Buena pregunta.
Well, it's hard to narrow it down, but the first thing that popped into my head was Howard Roberts Is a Dirty Guitar Player. I love that record. I got it when I was 14. My first guitar teacher gave it to me. And it's a underrated, great jazz record. I mean, there's Wes Montgomery, and there's some obvious guys that are like genius that made some great records. But it's almost like a pop jazz record, and don't be scared by the pop word, the P word. It's like really concise, and he's got an organist. I think the organist is kick and bass, but they do like Satin Doll, and it's completely inventive and funky. One Note Samba, and the arrangements are tight. It's like if the Beatles made a jazz record. And it was a great jazz record for me to get. Really good. What else popped into my head? Julie Is Her Name with Barney Kessel on guitar. It's Julie London, not Julie Andrews. Julie London's first record has Cry Me a River on it, which I covered on Heaven Is Creepy, but we don't need to talk about that. That's a very old record. anyway. It's a great record. She's 20 years old, and Barney plays, again, kind of pop jazz guitar. Very concise versions. There's an amazing version of Laura on there, too. That's really dreamy. They put a ton of reverb on Julie London's voice. Julie London, do you guys know who Jack Webb is? Dragnet? No? Anyway, old American, you know, U.S. show about cops.
Okay.
And Dan Aykroyd parried it. Yeah. Dan Aykroyd, a genius. Anyway, she was married to Jack Webb, which is a real jaw dropper, you know, but he must have been different in real life, I guess.
I know Barney Kessel through Stevie Ray Vaughan that we talk about, because Vaughan played a song of him.
Which one?
Chitlins with Carne.
Oh, right.
Ah.
Ah, and no me tenían fe. This song.
Mira cómo tapa cámara de nuevo.
I know es el because this song.
Is it well? There.
Pasa derecho, Sergio. Dale,
sí, y yo también quiero vino.
Aparte es un honor que tapa la cámara.
Claro.
Sergio, no.
Maybe Mariano should sing that song through the rest of this interview. And Mariano Otero.
Otero,
bro. And Sergio Verdinelli.
Yeah.
Verdinelli.
So that's two. The other one. The other one that pops into my head is Merle Haggard Live in Muskogee, and I got that kind of on as a joke. I went on a date. I was, I think, 17 or 18 years old, and boy, I wanted this girl. You know, she was way out of my league. And so I asked her to lunch, and she goes, okay. You know, I guess she must have been very desperate. So we travel. I'm living in the Bay Area. We go to Mill Valley, and we're supposed to get lunch, and I see a record store, and I'm like, hey, can we go in here for a sec? And, you know, and she's like, okay. So I end up finding a bunch of records that I really wanted, and then I saw Merle Haggard Live in Muskogee, and it was $1, and I thought, oh, this is that like guy who hates hippies and hates pot, and I thought, I'll get it, it'll be funny, you know? So anyway, the reason I had that, you know, intro with the date is I bought the records, and I was like, oh, I don't have any money. So I had to go to her. She's like, so you ready for lunch? I'm like, well. And so we had to go back home. And she was not very happy. But so anyway, I put that record on and I'm thinking it'll be like if, I don't know, like who's one of those like right-wing talk show host guys? The one guy who just got fired. Like in the U.S., you know, guys who talk conspiracies.
You know, del podcast.
Yeah, I can't remember his name, and that's kind of good.
How do you say it?
Like Alex Jones or something. Not him, but he's really extreme. Okay. But it would be like, to me, like, oh, Alex Jones made a record, you know, and he's going to hate hippies and pot. And I listened to it, and I was like, wow, this is pretty good. And I put on side two, and there's a song called If I Left It Up to You. And I listened to it like maybe 6-7 times in a row. I was like, wow, I really like this. And I thought, oh, I'll learn the guitar. It'll be easy because it's country. You know, like at the time it was like I was playing pentatonic stuff, and to play country, you just go, oh, I just put it everything here, right? You know what I mean? Like Allman Brothers E, but not as
you
good.
You move the position.
Yeah, like rock, country, right? And so I thought, and it didn't work. And it was Roy Nichols. And it took me a couple of days to learn the solo. And because of that, I really got inside it and then tried to learn the other songs are just as brilliant. It's a great record because it's live and the mayor's there. He gives Merle a key to the city. You know, it's a great record. So that one, I highly recommend it. I've recommended it before. Then it gets, you know, Hendrix.
Obviously.
The first record I ever bought was, LP. The first LP I bought was Jimi Hendrix's Greatest Hits. I told that to somebody. It has the poster of them with horses. Jimi Hendrix Smash Hits, it might be called. And there's kind of like this. But it's the singles.
Yeah.
But I bought it for Red House. I really liked it. I told somebody that once because we were doing at a party. I don't know. Somebody said, what's the first record you ever bought? And the person before me said, like, the Monkees. And somebody else said something, like, really lame. You know, the Archies. I don't know. And then I was like, Jimi Hendrix, Greatest Hits. And they were like, you're lying. And I was like, no, I'm not. But you know,
I think the same that the persons in the party. You're lying. Hendrix's first album is a lot.
It's like kind of cool.
Yeah, but
I don't know.
You start at the top.
I was like a little fat kid who went to Catholic school, but I was not cool. What's the first record you bought? It's LP.
Oh, I know. Roxette. I tell the truth.
Creo que Lennon.
It's not cool, Mike.
Lennon with Choco.
Otro.
He's lying.
Yes, I'm with you.
New York. ¿Cómo se llama? Living New York.
Canchero.
Pero
que era los 90. Sergio Bernelli, drummer.
Sergio?
First LP. Yes. First LP you ever bought.
Chris Morena.
No, this is
recopilation.
It's
not. No, it's not. I believe him. That's the second record I got with the White Album.
Mariano?
I don't know, but maybe.
Don't say Jaco Pastorius.
No, Led Zeppelin or.
Well, el único que soy yo.
No, pero la cosa no es mi dinero. Por eso
la banda. Por eso ustedes son músicos de eximios y yo hago pedales.
You don't know?
Yo, el primer disco que me compré ya era grande, porque yo primero escuché CDs. Mira, el primer CD que me compré fue de los Ramones: All the Stuff and More.
Sigue siendo canchero.
Porque cuando salían. No, te voy a explicar por qué. Porque cuando salieron los CDs, había muy pocos CDs.
Sí.
Había The Police.
Claro.
Oh. Dire Straits.
Dire Straits, always.
Y los Ramones. Y le compré. Los Ramones, después me compré.
I believe him.
It's a good story.
Y después me compré el LP. Después empecé a comprar vinilo. Cuando empecé a comprar vinilo, empecé a comprar todos los clásicos que yo tenía: los Stones, Beatles, Led Zeppelin, Hendrix, o bueno, en qué orden.
Primer CD.
Perdí.
Primer CD.
First CD.
Mike Stern.
No.
Julian Lage. Julian Lage.
Johann Sebastian Bach.
Wolfgang.
God. Maybe she.
One more really good guitar record, and maybe your listening audience wouldn't expect it.
Yes.
The Plastic Ono band.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, with I Found Out. And Plastic Ono band. I mean, guitarists like don't mention that record, but I always found John Lennon a really powerful guitarist.
Wow.
Even the side two on Abbey Road, the dunk, 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 dunk. What's the name of that song? Dunk, dunk. Anyway, and they have
the don't know the name of the song.
Yeah, you know which one. It's like they're all cut in together. I usually know it. But him, George Harrison, and Eric Clapton trade like fours or something.
It's the time that Clapton is in love with the wife.
Yeah. Yes. I guess.
Clapton.
Yeah. You know, that lasted a while.
Danger.
It didn't work out. But John ends up blowing them all away.
Yes.
And, you know, because John could really play.
Yes.
And dunk, da 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 da. You know that one? Wow. It's really good stuff, man.
I feel fine,
though.
I feel fine.
I feel fine.
Ahora
that's John.
Que tu primer disco fue
That's a great. It's on a short scale guitar, which helps.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a smaller because that's. I think it's pretty stretchy. But anyway, those are off the top of my head. We've only had one question, and I think the interviews lasted an hour and a half.
It's like that. We want.
Okay.
To
yeah. I'm good.
Yes. Today. Pardon.
No, voy a intentar hacer una pregunta, pero va a ser muy difícil y me
Así
van a ayudar. Entre ustedes me van a ayudar. Mi pregunta es...
Decir
al castellano.
Wait a minute. Yeah.
I'm going
to
say in Spanish first. Para que está Otero... Ese es Otero. Yeah. Para que la gente sepa que es tapa notable. No es que pasa cualquier pelotudo acá y tapa la
pantalla.
En un show sin efectos, manejas la dinámica entre tu momento de más emoción y el de cómo manejas la dinámica cuando tocas en vivo sin artilugios. Y ahora viene la parte en inglés que es durísima.
No, pero
How do you manage the dynamics with no pedals? From the epic moment to the little phrase. How do you do with your hands?
Well, how do you do it with boxes?
He talked that with boxes is simplifier for him.
Well,
about that.
I mean, okay. Like, I think it's harder with pedals to have dynamics.
Wow.
I mean, the other thing is why are vintage instruments $15,000, $20,000, $25,000? Like, what makes that a vintage instrument?
Yes.
Like, sometimes maybe it doesn't. You know, it's just like the model it was. But I think when I play a vintage instrument, it's dynamic. Like, you could really touch it. You can strike it very softly, and it projects something. And you hit it harder, and it projects that. And I think that's the essence of a vintage instrument, that it's really dynamic. And I think that takes time, I guess. I don't know. It's a mystical thing, thank God, right?
Yes.
So, and what's unfortunate, I think, is most people who buy those guitars, who could afford those guitars, don't play dynamically. Yes. They play
don't
like...
Don't play.
Well, they don't play at all. Yeah. I mean, or they go dun 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 like the I'm a Badass blues lick. And they don't play dynamically, okay? But I think it's much easier to have a relationship with your right hand, assuming you're a right-handed player, without effects.
Wow. Yes.
It's, well, that's a little vulgar analogy. But you can, you know, you can feel it. I think it's a good question, and I've actually heard that question, but I think it's so obvious. El obvio. Come on.
Bien. Yeah. Vintage. 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 Yeah. Yo pensé que era vintage.
Did I answer that question?
Yes. Okay. Las tres personas que tenemos acá son de los tres mejores músicos que hay en este momento en la Argentina. Así que me interesa entender cómo arman un show, cómo lo piensan, porque por ahí nos sirva a todos. Así que va a ir por ese lado la pregunta. No sé si es una pregunta así. I want to talk about the trio and the rehearsal and how you glue the music or you make that it happen or you understand in any scenario.
Well,
how did it happen?
I'll answer first, even though I've been doing all the talking. I think great musicians create chemistry.
Okay.
Like that's what they do.
Wow.
Like okay. I mean, you know, you could say sidemen if you want, but great musicians create chemistry by their sensitivity, by their depth, by their experience. And I think that's Sergio and Mariano. I don't know. I mean, maybe we're lucky, and I think we like the same things. I think we like melodic music, but I think I can't take credit for that, and I can't say that we've rehearsed so much. I think the best I could answer that, but okay. It does work, and usually the way I work usually is I don't, and I think this is true, I don't over-instruct. I kind of go, hey, I got a car, here's the car keys. Like, wow. You know, kind of like, and...
But you know what you want. You know what you want.
Do I?
Yeah, you know what you want to hear. Uh-huh. And this is why you don't give so much explanation, because of you're looking for a scene.
Yes, do you hear?
You're looking for people that understand what you want instead of your explanation, you know? Uh-huh. It's the way of found musician that gave you the chemistry with no words, without... Okay, let's play the knees. Let me how you read the, how you feel the knees. If you feel the same that I'm feeling, uh-huh. We're okay. If I have to explain it to you, you're not okay, maybe. Okay.
Right.
If you have the possibility, you prefer to rehearsal 2 months of directly what to play.
No rehearsal.
I do. The thing I enjoy most in music is probably rehearsing.
Oh, okay.
Because sometimes the audience. And again, I'm hesitant to say this because I don't want sometimes the audience charges you and gives you so much back. And it's a cycle. Like they give you energy and you give the energy back to them and they give you energy. It's not look at me. It's
okay.
Give me something, I'll give it back. Yes. And it's a circular thing.
Yes.
But I really enjoy just playing for the musicians. And connecting with them and looking at them and, you know, smiling. And that's easier at rehearsal. And then it's also kind of fun to talk about the song, like go, hey, maybe after the solo, drop out for a couple bars and we'll go do, 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 dum, 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 you know, like or something like that. I really enjoy that. But I do enjoy gigs, you know. I'm really looking forward to tonight, and so. But I like rehearsing a lot, but we never do it.
I need the opinion from Sergio.
Yes, I want to hear from Sergio.
En castellano.
Sí. No, me re gustó lo que dijo Jimmy, lo que dijo Mariano también, de que viste lo de crear química, como que uno trata de hacerlo funcionar, viste. Y después siempre te sacaste un poco de la leche de tratar todas las porquerías que tenía ganas de tratar en el momento que lo tenías que hacer. Después por ahí te enganchás, viste, con tocar algo un poco más, buscar por ahí por otros lados, crear atmósfera.
Viste que lo que es él, ¿no? Que toca una nota así, pum, y ya estás recolocado, ¿no? Sí. Y entonces aprovechar eso, ¿viste? Bueno, si él tocó una nota y se armó, ya nosotros tenemos que poder subirnos a eso e intentar hacer eso.
Qué lindo.
I think that was good. I wish I understood.
When I listen a guitar player, I always think in Luis Miguel. You know Luis Miguel?
No.
He's like Frank Sinatra from Latin America. He's a singer from that sing boleros.
Oh, I bet I'd like that.
Mexican.
Mexico.
Oh. He has a great, great voice. Uh-huh. And I always think that his voice is his tone, mm-hmm. his guitar tone, no? So I think that and the people loves him from his tone, from his voice sound. I want to know that when I listen to you, I think that way. I think that you work your tone that way, that you know that the people will connect with your voice.
Well, that's true. Most of the songs I write, I sing, and then I record myself singing it. And a lot of times I just go back and go, what the hell was I singing? And usually it doesn't fall well on the guitar. You know, it's not do-do-do-do. Oh, now it's country. It's always kind of like you have to go back and then back. Yeah. But I really like torch singers. One I really, really liked and still like is somebody who, Andy, I was going to say Andy Williams and that's not it. What's his name? I have all his records.
What he sings?
Oh, nobody knows this guy. It's like, literally you'd get his records by filling up your tank at a gas station in the 60s. And he was a swimmer, and he died young, and he became a hippie, and then that kind of ruined his career. Oh, hell. And I can't think of his name. But he's like Andy Williams, like Hawaiian Wedding Song.
Yes.
I have him on my iPhone.
Well, like, then we put on the video the name of
the but I've learned his... vocal lines. I've learned Billie Holiday's vocal lines. That was other something, you know, significant is, you know, when I was in high school or whatever, I heard jazz and it just sounded really weird to me. You know, it was like, it's autumn in New York. You know, it just sounded like, what? You know, what is this? Like I wanted, you know, last night I said these words to my, or, you know, that spoonful. So I heard jazz and I'm like, man, this is weird. And then I heard Billie Holiday and I heard what she was saying. And it was like, don't worry about me, you know, and songs I really related to. And so I learned her vocal lines on the guitar. So a lot of stuff I do or did, I'll learn what the vocalist is doing. I did it with Norah Jones. Like when I was in the Willies, like I'd bring a little, you know, my iPhone and record it. And a lot of times I think what she's singing is really interesting. Okay. And so I'd learn some of those grace notes that vocalists do. And again, they don't fall. I mean, I'm not saying it's like, you know, Alan Holdsworth, but it's like if you're in G, you have to play A. You have to either reach down for it on the second fret, third string, or reach up with it, fourth finger on the seventh fret. I'm still trying to think of that singer who I love, who's influenced me. You know, it's like clumsy and it's like a note in the scale, and a lot of singers sing those things. So anyway,
You always play things in music. We will edit that
Scale?
No, you never think in guitar mode. You always think in music mode, in singer, in
I guess.
Horn,
I mean, I don't know. You know, I wish I was a lot better.
It's the same about us.
You know, it's hard for me to thank you, but you know, I hope to have a few moments. Like, if there's a, and last night we had quite a few. The gig before Vera Soro, second set, there were some moments, you know.
Okay. You think in moments?
In, you know, sometimes a moment is long, but like 70 seconds, you know. But it's kind of like, I don't know, it's like a kiss or something, right? Like if you're going to go, I'm going to kiss my girlfriend tonight and it's going to be the best. You know what I mean? Like, you don't know. You don't know. And I wish we all did. And it's not unpleasant, but sometimes it's a moment.
Yes.
And sometimes it's not.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Yes. Well, thank you. I think the word is hermosa or bonito. I think. Anyway, so I think I answered that question.
Yes, yes, okay. It's perfect.
Thanks, Jim.
Yes, it's a lot of fun.
Thank you. You know, we had the best barbecue.
Cubes, you said, great. Barbecue, man.
Oh, it was
barbecue.
Great. And Sergio Verdinelli and Mariano Otero.
Yeah. I will talk a little in Spanish for our audience.
Okay, but you know, let's hear it for these guys. They're so great.
Barbecue. No, excelente, barbecue.
No, como despedida solo quiero decir que todavía no los vi a trío, pero que hoy ya sé que vamos a ver una cosa grandiosa, así que espero que los tengan cerca y puedan venir a ver este show, que lo vayan a ver, porque es increíble.
Tenemos, que lo vayan a ver.
El objeto de tener tres tipos que tocan increíble tocando juntos y una música hermosa y preocupado por tocar música y no por tocar para ellos, espero que todos vayan a ver esto. Así que nada, dejo eso. Y la verdad es que en 3-4 meses va a volver Jim. Así que lo van a poder ver constantemente. Jim is an Argentinian person. You can see it in every moment. So if you don't see it in this visit, you will visit. You will see it in the next visit, 3 months, 4 months.
I hope so.
We have a fidelity for you to...
He's a world champion today.
Beware of answered prayers. What was the name of that band? He killed.
He kills. I show.
Man.
He like El Tesoro.
What's the name of that song?
The Treasure.
How old is that?
No,
5 years.
Oh, good. It's new music. Man, I love that.
Thanks
for waiting, you guys. Poor guys have to fucking hear me talk all the time.
Two genius.